they are going to be affected, and this also can affect our national team, both the Flying Eagles and also the Super Eagles and even the Olympic team also, because most of these players right now, they play in the local league. And so the step they are taking is the right step. But let's just hope that, you know, this meeting will bring an end to all these things, and let's just move forward. Let's move forward from
here. Tunde made a point about a compromise.
Yeah.
You don't expect that everybody will remain 100% on their position.
Yeah.
The club owners will shift. The LMC probably would also shift. That's what I expect.
Yeah.
But if I may ask you, where would you want a shift to come from? for the LMC, where would you want a shift? Because clearly in a compromise, we can't maintain our positions. So, we need to come to the center. Yeah. I give some away, you give some away, we can come to the center and try to work things out. So,
I think if you look at it, I think the best thing is just that, you know, the LMC should just, you know, try to, you know, listen to the club owners, as in agree to what they want. Because if you look at it, these guys have been in this business for a long time. The Ndukara Ball-led board, you know, they came in just to put
more sanity. Like a committee.
Yeah, they just came in to put sanity into our football. Because if you look at it, the last year MPL board that we had, you know, they didn't do too well for me. They didn't do too well. But, you know, with Ndukara Ball coming in, we believe that, you know, it can bring a change into our football. It can make it, you know, to be better than what we've been seeing. And he has shown it. He has taken the right step. And I believe it can work. But maybe the way, you know, he took the step, and that is what is annoying the club owners, that, you know, they are not being hinted that this is what is going to happen. And they are the major players in this game. So I think the I want the LMC, you know, to just try to shift a little bit, listen to what the club owners want. Though they might not agree 100%, like he are saying, they might not compromise 100%, but at least let us, for peace to reign and for
something must give,
our football to go on. Let
me ask you before we go on to something different. What shift are you expecting from the club owners? I mean, they said they are not going to work with the LMC anymore. That was their last press conference, that they don't want to recognize them. Surely that must change. They must shift some ground.
Exactly.
Understand the intent of the LMC. For the LMC, probably they will also look at some of the things that they've done and try to maybe make some adjustments to involve the clubs more. Maybe in the allocation of shares or decision taking or regular meetings, something must just happen. And there must be some compromise between these two bodies.
I think we can all agree.
Mm.
We here, even the gentlemen who are meeting in Abuja and every Nigerian on the street, that something has to be done drastically to change the face of league football in Nigeria.
Our football cannot continue the way
it is. This is
club administration.
This is a system that has existed for over decades.
And has not moved us forward.
And has shown that.
Surely.
So we understand that.
Yes.
So if
which is what the LMC is trying to change.
He's trying to change.
Yes.
So the club owners too must do some sort of soul searching and look, maybe this will have a point.
Do we want to continue this way?
Do we want to continue this way?
And not move forward.
We've seen other examples of other leagues around the world
making progress.
How profitable marketing, everything, beauty is working,
to watch, security,
stands, everything. So how do we move from where we are to where we want to be? So obviously they have to first agree that something has to be done. Next, they have to also look at what is it that is being offered by the LMC. How can it, is it workable? Is it cast in stone? Or can we make adjustments? Can we make suggestions? That also has to be said. Then, from the future in view, this is a long-term project. It's not a short, medium-term project. Then the LMC themselves, they also have to look at what they have done so far, how well they have done it, and what has the fruits of what they've done. What has it brought forth so far? They also look at their methods in implementing their own change as well. Has it gone down well with the parties involved? Can they do anything better? Then there's also the particularly contentious issue of shares allocation. That has also been a major, major talking point on both sides of the divide. Now they must now come to a consensus. What exactly, who owns what? In the English Premier League that we mentioned, the FA owns just a minimal percentage of it. The vast majority is owned by the club. So all these things must be worked out in order to ensure that there's equity and happiness.
All right. Talking about League Management Committee, we said something on the show yesterday. Cano Pillars, Atlan. Well, this is boardroom. I mean, what is going on right now is in the boardroom. That's the club owners and the LMC. What about football on the pitch? Cano Pillars, and Atland, their game that was abandoned, is to be replayed on the 29th of May in Abuja. That's what we are told, that Kano Pillars will have to replay that game against Atland in Abuja on the 29th of May. And these are the pictures from that game for us to have a clear understanding of what actually happened at the Sani Abacha Stadium when this game was played last Wednesday. I think so. I think it was last Wednesday it was played. I mean, the two teams came out. There was no problem. You could even see players of both teams exchanging pleasantries because they know themselves.
Fans already in the
stands. Everybody already in the stands. And
the match formalities already been conducted.
Apologies for the quality of the visuals, but I hope we can just allow you to see as it goes on. Yeah. Everything was going smoothly. Referees, teams, and the game was
the match was ready to be played.
In fact, the game has started.
Yeah.
Until, I mean, this is the kickoff of the game. As you can see, Pillars and the stadium. Usually in Kano, the stadium fills up gradually after kickoff. It fills up gradually, and everything was going on until the ugly incident where the point of disagreement is, was there encroachment on the field of play? We were told that the incident happened outside of the arena, but in the stadium, was there encroachment? And you can see that here, the fans are beginning to move, and some of them were clearly beginning to walk onto the pitch. You could see. So clearly, I mean, you can see that particular fan even jogging. I mean, I think this is the match that Atlant could capture before their cameraman was told to stop recording. Or was at the risk of even having himself.
But with these pictures, it is clear that I think Atlant took a very, very, very wise decision. Obviously,
no football continue games like this
in this kind of kind of atmosphere where anything could
happen.
You know, it could degenerate even further. Mm. Yes, it didn't happen in the stadium, for what we were told. But obviously, what happened outside the stadium had affected proceedings in the stadium.
Mm.
There was no way
that game could have continued
in that kind of situation, and I think they made the wise decision. Also, there are questions whether they could have been awarded the 3 points and the 3 goals, considering the fact that they did not constitute a nuisance, they did not try and stop play.
The fans of the Kano Pillars walked onto the pitch, and security couldn't be guaranteed. All right, so that's how it is. But we are told that the game will be replayed. I'm sure some concessions were given on the 29th of May in Abuja. All right, that's a situation report from that Kano Pillars Atland game, decision by the league management committee. Well, before we go on the break, Madrid have finally broken the ice. Karim Benzema has scored a goal, but is it a case of a little too late? So it's Madrid leading at the moment by 1-0, and we have a few minutes more to the end of the game. We've seen